Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with our chapter of book number 2, the second chapter, which earlier its name was India's External Relations and now its new name is India's Foreign Policy. Under its beginning, we will start with the first objectives of the India's foreign policy and what were the main principles of India's foreign policy. Under article number 51, the objectives of India's foreign policy, जिसे हम नेहरूवियन पॉलिसी भी कहते हैं, आर्टिकल 51 में इंडिया हैज अडॉप्टेड सर्टेन प्रिंसिपल्स टू रियलाइज द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. अंडर दैट, प्रमोशन ऑफ इंटरनेशनल पीस एंड सिक्योरिटी, फ्रेंडली रिलेशंस इंडिया बाकी कंट्रीज के साथ रखेगा, इंटरनेशनल लॉ और इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जैसे कि यूएन है उनके लिए रिस्पेक्ट शो करेगा, एंड इट विल सॉल्व ऑल द डिस्प्यूट्स ऑफ इंटरनेशनल लेवल पीसफुली. These were the main objectives that were enshrined in DPSP, Directive Principles of State Policy, in the Constitution of India. And Panchsheel, it was signed on 28th April 1954 between Chinese Prime Minister Chou Enlai and Indian Prime Minister Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Under Panchsheel, mutual respect for each other's territorial integrity and sovereignty. The respect will be shown towards integrity and sovereignty of every nation. Internally and externally, a nation is free to decide its own matter. Non-aggression over against each other, and there will be no interference in each other's internal affairs. Equality and mutual benefit. All the states are equal. Bharat ki videsh niti ka main रूट ही यही है कि सभी नेशंस इक्वल हैं एंड दे विल वर्क फॉर द म्यूचुअल बेनिफिट ऑफ ईच अदर एंड पीसफुल कोएग्जिस्टेंस. आपस में पीसफुली दे रिस्पेक्ट द कोएग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ अदर मेंबर्स एंड ऑल दीज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ पंचशील दे विल इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन बांदुंग डिक्लेरेशन दैट वाज साइंड इन 1955 इन इंडोनेशिया इन द आफ्रो एशियन कॉन्फ्रेंस. So the core principles of non-alignment, they are still the guiding principles of India's foreign policy. The first principle that has started non-alignment, not to join any military bloc. After World War II, in the period of Cold War, the two blue power blocs were made. One was under the leadership of USA and the other was under the leadership of Soviet Union. India has not joined any of the power bloc, and it is not a policy of neutrality or non-involvement, but it is a very positive and dynamic concept to take active participation in all the happenings of the world, in all the problems and issues. So we can't call them as a ideal of neutrality. For this reason only, India's non-alignment policy got many supporters from the countries of Asia, Africa and Latin America. These countries have supported amid the Cold War tensions and Cold War pressures. Under the foreign policy of India, India is resisting towards colonialism, imperialism and racialism. For the first time, India spoke in United Nations in 1946. It was the first nation to bring the issue of apartheid in United Nations in 1946. And moreover, 14 African countries were liberated from the yoke of colonialism in 1964, and these were all the efforts of India towards non-aligned movement. And there was one African fund also set up in 1986 to help the frontline states which were the victims of aggression of South Africa for supporting the cause of fight against apartheid. Frontline states ki help ke liye African fund bhi banaya gaya, and for that India is continuously opposing the colonialism, imperialism and racism. India is against these kinds of discrimination that are being made in the whole world. Peaceful settlement of international disputes. Directive principles में भी लिखा गया है और United Nations के charter में भी mention है that every problem, any dispute should be solved peacefully. चाहे कश्मीर issue हो, Korean conflict हो, Palestinian issue हो, या फिर democratic upsurge जो Middle East में आपने देखा है, अभी democratization के लिए जो स्टेप्स उठाए जा रहे हैं, वहाँ के प्रोटेस्ट हो रहे हैं लोगों के द्वारा, तो इन सभी इश्यूज का डेमोक्रेटिक वे से, एक पीसफुल वे से सेटल डाउन होना ही इंडिया की फॉरेन पॉलिसी का एक मेजर कंसर्न रहा है. एंड इंडिया इज ऑलवेज अगेंस्ट द फॉरेन मिलिट्री इंटरवेंशन फॉर रिजॉल्विंग द इंटरनेशनल प्रॉब्लम्स. इंडियन फॉरेन पॉलिसी में हर एक डिस्प्यूट को शांतिपूर्वक ढंग से निपटाने का प्रयास किया जाता है एंड इट इज वन ऑफ द गाइडिंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ इंडियाज फॉरेन पॉलिसी. सपोर्ट टू यूएन, इंटरनेशनल लॉ एंड अ जस्ट एंड इक्वल वर्ल्ड ऑर्डर. इंडिया हैज ऑलवेज सपोर्टेड द कॉज ऑफ डिसआर्ममेंट. इंटरनेशनल लॉ के लिए डिसआर्ममेंट की पॉलिसी यूनाइटेड नेशंस ने के द्वारा इंडिया ने सपोर्ट की है. And India has proposed a very ambitious program of nuclear disarmament, which was not accepted by other members of the UN. But India still stands for the cause of universal disarmament, that there should be no arms used and attained by any of the country. And it has also played a very key role in preserving world peace by helping the decolonization program, by actively participate in UN peacekeeping activities. World peace के लिए decolonization process में India ने बहुत important role play किया है और moreover अपनी peacekeeping forces वो अलग अलग स्थानों पर ज़रूरत पड़ने पर भेजता रहता है. And to make Security Council more and more democratic, India has proposed and it has supported the reform of Security Council and other UN agencies. For this, I want to tell you that this year when the voting happened, out of 192 countries, 184 countries voted in the favor of India to be the permanent membership of Security Council. Security Council ki permanent membership ke liye India ka support 184 countries ne kiya hai. This is all with today's point. These were the guide principles of India's foreign policy. Tomorrow we will start with India's relations with China and what was the recent relations with China and what were the upsurges between these two nations. This is all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.